The hair that I will be using today is from the Jazzy Hair Collection, and she is located on 281 in Stone Oak, and you can go see her at Hair Studio 55. I got 3 bundles of body wave and the 20-inch frontal. I'll be using 50 Volume Developer, Purple Shampoo, and some Quick Blue. I let it sit on there for about 30 minutes, but I watch it so that I won't over bleach. Now that it's all washed out, I'm gonna go ahead and put the purple shampoo on there and leave it on there for about 10 to 15 minutes and let it sit. So now your frontal should be looking like this, and now it's time to go ahead and put some conditioner on there, let it sit for a little bit, rinse it out, and then I'll be right back. Now it's time for plucking. I get so many questions on plucking. Y'all don't know what plucking is. What's the point of plucking? Well, I'm here to let y'all know. Plucking is to thin out the hairline. You do not want it to look bulky. You do not want it to look wiggy, because that's not natural. So you pluck, ladies, because if you don't pluck, you're not gonna look your best. And I'm trying to help y'all out. So just go ahead and pluck. Take section by section, thin out the hairline, pluck, skip apart, pluck, skip apart. Just keep doing that until it look realistic. Started with gluing this wig down. I'm using Gorilla Glue because I heard is the stronger hold. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try that out. And I got this method from the Beautiful Hustler on YouTube. So y'all can go ahead and check her channel out because she make bomb hair videos, y'all. When pinning the frontal down, you want to make sure that it's in an M shape. So go ahead and pin the middle down first, and then you'll see it start to look like an M. And then you're going to go ahead and pin the left side and the right side. I went ahead and put two braids in so I can get the hair out the way. But now it's time to sew down the frontal. And I always sew down the frontal because you don't want that frontal sliding nowhere, just in case the glue doesn't hold. But not saying that it won't, but just in case. Always sew the frontal down. Okay, now that this side is sewed down, I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side off camera, and I'll be back when it's completed. Now it's time to glue the tracks on. So I'm gonna tell y'all a funny story. I was really doing this the long way, and then I realized towards the end that all I gotta do is unscrew the cap on the glue and I can just put it on there like I was putting on regular glue. But don't mind me, y'all. Don't be like me. Just unscrew the cap and lay the glue on the tracks the regular way and not with that little brush.
You just waste my time, so I don't pay no mind, no.
we can go ahead and cut the cap off from the wig. Please be careful not to cut too far over there by the frontal, or your whole wig just gonna fall apart. Now it's time for the best part, y'all, the baby hairs. And I'm not gonna lie, I've been practicing with baby hairs. It's always been a struggle for me, but I'm gonna show y'all how I do mine, and then maybe it can actually help y'all do yours. Okay, y'all, so this is how the wig came out. I'm gonna go ahead and put it on my head, take a couple pictures, and show y'all the glow up, okay? Make sure y'all don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know how I did, and if y'all want to see more hair videos. Thanks for watching.